Good morning to everyone. Today we are start our next lecture on machine design and drawing tool. And today's topic is numerical or design of coupling. In previous lecture, we can see the introduction of design of coupling. We are seeing the shaft coupling, then requirement of good shaft coupling, then types of shaft coupling also. In types of shaft coupling, there are two types. First one is the rigid coupling and second one is the flexible coupling. In rigid coupling, there are also three types. From that, first one is the Muff slim coupling. As well as we can see that the introduction of design of Muff slim coupling also. And today we are start numerical on design of coupling, design of Muff coupling. On that lecture, we have already written the problems to avoid the duration of our lecture. Okay, so first write down the problem. You see also on the screen the design of coupling problem. The design of Muff coupling, which is used to connect two steel shaft transmitting 40 kilowatt at 350 rpm, and the material for the shaft and key is plain carbon steel. Is plain carbon steel for which allowable shear and crushing stress may be taken as 40 MPa and 80 MPa respectively. The material of the Muff is cast iron, for which the allowable shear stress may be assumed as 15 MPa. Okay, these are our complete problem. From that we can see one by one. First, as per the problem, you can see some given conditions. First, they can give the P. P is 40 kilowatt. 40 kilowatt means 40 × 10³ watt. Then RPM, speed. That is the N equal to 350 RPM. And shear stress for the shaft, that is tau S equal to 40 MPa. It means 40 Newton per mm square. Then sigma Cs. Sigma Cs equal to 80 MPa. Equal to 80 Newton per mm square. Then tau C means your crushing stress for the cast iron, shear stress for the cast iron equal to 15 MPa, it means 15 Newton per mm square. These are our given condition. Then after that we are calculating the design of Muff coupling. In design of Muff coupling, we are design of shaft, design of Muff and design of key. From that, first we can design of shaft. In design of shaft, first we can check the torque transmitted by the shaft. In torque transmitted by the shaft, that is P. P equal to 2 × 10^16. We are already given power. So P equal to 2 × 10^16. From that, P is 40 × 10³ equal to 2 × π × 350 × T/16. From that, your torque T equal to 1091.9 Nm. But when we are calculating the diameter of shaft, they are always required in millimeter. So the torque also we can convert it on mm. So T equal to 1091.9 × 10³ Nm. Okay, then pi by 16 tau dq, pi by 16 tau dq. From that, 1091.9 into 10 to the power 3, that is your torque, then equal to pi by 16 into 40, 40 is your tau into dq. From that, you have also parallelly calculated the problem. From the, after that, the d diameter, you are calculating the diameter, d is 51.80 mm. Okay, but we are required our design is set, so you can modify that the diameter of the shaft, that is d equal to 56 mm. Okay, you can safely design, you are required to make a safely design your coupling, so d equal to 56 mm. Then now here design of shaft is clear. Then second step is your design of sleeve, design of sleeve, or the, you can say that design of muff also. Then the outer diameter of the muff, that is your capital D. Capital D equal to twice D plus 30 mm. In previous lecture we have already see the some formulas related to your muff coupling. Then capital D equal to 2 into 56 plus 13, it means capital D equal to 125 mm. Then next one is your length of the muff. Length of the muff, that is capital L. Capital L equal to 3.5 times D. Then 3.5, and your D, you have already calculated your D is 56 mm. So as for that, length of muff, capital L equal to 196 mm. Okay, now check the induced shear stress in muff. Okay, then let tau C means tau cast iron. Your material of muff is cast iron. So let tau C be the induced shear stress in muff, which is made of cast iron. It's already given in your problem also. Your material of the muff is cast iron. Then, since the muff is a hollow shaft, okay, muff itself, it's like a hollow shaft. So T equal to pi by 16 into tau d to the power 4 minus small d to the power 4 upon capital D. This formula is only required for the hollow shaft. As for the previous one, at the time of your design of shaft, we are using T equal to pi by 16 tau into dq, and that is for the solid shaft. This formula is used for solid shaft, and T equal to pi by 16 tau into capital D to the power 4 minus small d to the power 4 upon capital D. It's used for only for hollow shaft. Okay, so then 1091.9 into 10 to the power 3 equal to pi by 16 into tau. Then 125 to the power 4 minus 56 to the power 4 upon 125. From that, we are calculating your tau, and tau is your 2.97 newton per mm square. 2.97 newton per mm square, that is your tau. You are calculating with the help of your hollow shaft, with the formula of your hollow shaft. But since the induced shear stress in the muff is less than the permissible stress, because given condition the permissible stress is given, it's the 15 megapascal. Okay, and you are calculating 2.97. It means 2.97 is less than 15 megapascal. So therefore, the design of muff or design of sleeve is safe. Okay. So as per the up to this one, design of shaft is completed and design of muff or design of sleeve is completed. After that, Next one is your design of key. Next one is your design of key. But when you start the design of key, you always know about the diameter of shaft also, because the design of key is dependent on diameter of shaft. So from the design data book, we all are now, we are using the Mahadevan data book. So from that, on the table number 4.1, you can check your dimensions of key. So from the design data book, you are calculating the 56 mm, but as per your table, nearer about 256, it's 58 mm. You are observing your table carefully, because it's the most important part on your design. Whenever you are calculating your design of shaft, you can always check nearer amount nearer to your design of shaft. And design of shaft, you are calculating 56 mm, so nearer value is your 58 mm. So from above what we are calculating the design of key, we are using the diameter of shaft is 58 mm. Okay, so as per the diameter of shaft is 58 mm, you check the width of the key. Width of key W equal to 18 mm, and since the crushing stress for the key material, is twice the shearing stress, therefore square key is used. Because whenever you are using any key at the time of your crushing, they can reduce. Okay, they can crush. So we are using at that place square key. When we are using the square key, so width of the key is equal to your thickness of key. So thickness of key, is equal to W equal to 18 mm. It means now up to this one, at the time of your design of key, first you can check your diameter of shaft. From nearest value of diameter of shaft, you can check your width and thickness also. Okay, and now we are using the square key, so your thickness and width both are the same. It's your 18 mm. Okay, that's clear. Then next one is the length of key in each shaft. In previous also we can discuss about the coupling shaft. At the time of your coupling shaft, they can use both shaft. Okay, they can join both shaft, or they can join both coupling. So the length of key is equal to the length of shaft. So length of key in each shaft, that is small l equal to capital L by 2. Why is capital L by 2? Because capital L is the length of muff. Okay, it is length of muff. So small l equal to L by 2 equal to 196 by 2. So small l is 98 mm. Small l is 98 mm and capital L is 196 mm. Okay. Now check the shear crushing stress. Now check the induced shear crushing stress in the key. Then in the key you can check your shearing also and crushing also. You can check one by one. So first one, consider shearing of the key. Then at the time of your shear, that is P equal to L into L into means length into width into tau into D by 2. Because at the time of your shear, you can use your radius, and in your given conditions, diameter is given. So we are using D by 2. So from that, 109.9 into 10 to the power 3,
equal to 98 into 18 into tau into 56 by 2. Into 56 by 2. At that time, we are using the diameter is previous one because this is the calculated one, and at the time of dimensions of the key, you can use nearest value of your calculated one. So we are using 58 mm. Okay. So as for that, tau is 22.10 newton per mm square. That is this shear stress. Shear stress for the shaft is 22.10 newton per mm square. That is clear your shear stress. Then next, now considering the crushing stress of the key. Now we are using the crushing of the key. At that time, capital T is equal to L into T by 2 into sigma cs into D by 2. Okay, that is capital T is equal to L into T by 2 into sigma cs into D by 2. From that, 1091.9 into 10 to power 3 equal to 98 into, that is T is your 18 mm. So 18 by 2 into sigma cs into 56 by 2. From that, your sigma cs is equal to 44.21 newton per mm square. Since the induced shear and crushing stress are less than the permissible stress, okay. So you can check, you can the given value of your shear stress is 40 MPa. And the given value of your crushing stress is 80 MPa. As per that, you can calculate your shear stress is 22.10 MPa. It means it is less than 40 MPa. As well as calculating your crushing stress is 44.21 MPa. It is also less than 80 MPa. Therefore, the design of key is set because of both the calculating value is less than from given permissible value. Okay. Now here it is the complete numerical on Muff SGBAU coupling. Okay. So today's lecture we have stopped here. On next lecture we can discuss about next type of coupling. Thank you. Thank you, Dr.